There was a lot of elegance, even the way they chose to see themselves.
You're showing yourselves off. You want to be seen.
Very elegant, very stylized.
The Mayans had many styles of beauty. Looking good for the others was an obligation.
For her?
Yeah. There is actually a lot of information on how the Mayans wore their empire. The challenging thing was how to interpret all this.
This film, you've got the rich, you've got the young people, the old people, the very poor. There are all these different stratas of society. Wouldn't it be great if you could somehow visually convey that just through costumes? I think the reality is that Mel, as the creative force behind this film, allowed his key crew members the luxury, the freedom to go out there and come up with beautiful creative things, and they did it.
Amazing, amazing.
Well, the costume was a young woman called Mayas Rubeo from Mexico. She brought designs in and showed me pictures that were really exciting and kind of whetted my appetite to see more. And I knew that she had a real spirit of adventure and wanting to get in and do something really striking. I've never seen work like it, and I've seen a lot. I mean, that king's costume and the queen and some of these chaks and whole kings with these masks on it, it's wow, that's amazing.
To set all the different tones that we wanted to use, we made samples of all these colors from natural vegetables and animals that the Mayans used. For example, this beautiful red sienna comes from rojo cochinilla, and it gives you a variety of degrees of this kind of red. We also used indigo blue. So many hues in one single feather. And we actually were able to recreate a grin that comes from bladder of animals.
We're making costumes that nobody ever done.
The prints that you see have to be recreated because they did it freehand. We did about 50 different designs.
Patterns and embroidery that they have from those times.
Every single thing that you see in this movie is hand sewn. Handmade. You can't get any shortcuts because we shoot in 5 cameras all the time. It has to be perfect. The Mayans use a lot of jade. It was a symbol of wealth and happiness and trade and trust. But for logistic reasons, we couldn't have all this made out of jade. So we have to learn how to paint all these light materials into jade, just hand painting them.
All these bits are wood, and we have to make it look like if it was jade.
And it looks beautiful, just like jade.
The Mayas viewed status through the use of jade, exotic commodities like shell and mother of pearl. One of the most obvious things was the use of jade ear spools. So it would perforate the earlobe, a small piece of jade in, and then gradually expand that until it was able to accommodate a large ornament.
the things that are very, very original in this film stem from the fact that Mel, as an artist and as a filmmaker, is at a place where he can take those chances. Some of the things that you will see in this film, you will never have seen before.
The costume that I wear is so mythic. It belongs in every culture of a warrior society. But as soon as I put all of that leather armor on, I completely just, you know, become this character. It's like, oh my God, what is this? Is this an animal or a man? There's no work required other than to wear the costume.
Raul, signal those guys to move out.
It's like Mel says, you don't have to be scary. You are scary.
Try to look just straight out with your face. I mean, it is so, that's ominous.